We would like to use Excel for doing some basic calculation regarding association between these two variables. Say these are the values of the explanatory or the x variable, and these are the values of the response or the y variable. So we can do this. Select all the cells, go to Insert, go to Scatter, and once you press on the scatter plot, it will give you a scatter plot of the data. Okay, and now we can see how good a linear fit we can get here. So click on the layout for the trend line. Trend line, we are choosing the linear trend line, and then we may ask it to give us the equation and the R square, the coefficient of determination, and we can enlarge these fonts. All right, by doing this, just go ahead and choose a larger font, okay, and then we can make it bold. So you have this, that the slope of the line is 2.3209, and the y-intercept is negative 2.59 approximately, and this is the coefficient of determination. And here, since the slope is positive, the correlation will be the positive square root of this value. Okay, now what we would like to do is that we would like to test whether the slope is significantly different from zero and what a 95% confidence interval for the slope is. So what we do for that is this, that there is a feature called data analysis in Excel for some very basic regression calculations. So if you don't have it activated, just go ahead and click on options here, and then go to add-ins, and this is what you want, analysis tool pack. Say go, and see it's not checked in here, so I checked on it, said okay. And notice this, if I click on data here, it shows me that this data analysis tool pack is here. So you may click on that, okay? And then just look for regression here. And notice this is not really a statistical package. We are just using it for our basic calculation because we don't have any other statistical package available here. So we have this now. This is my y range, and this is my x range, and we don't have any labels on the top, so we'll leave it blank, and we want 95% confidence interval. So let's check on that and say okay. So here we have the values. Let's go ahead and enlarge the values, and our, you know, the part that is you know, that is of real interest to us is down here. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and enlarge that part so that I can read it for you. So I'm just going to enlarge this portion here, okay, or rather simply get this much. So let me enlarge it to this, and then yes, I have to do, sorry about that, okay, and right here. So what you notice is this, that as you saw in the previous sheet, that is the slope is 2.321 approximately, all right, and here the p-value for the slope is 0.0039, so it is a very small p-value, so we can conclude that the slope is significantly different from zero, and these are the bounds for the 95% confidence interval. This is the lower bound and this is the upper bound for this slope, okay?